Hey finders, welcome back to Fortune Finds. Today I'm going to be running you through my favorite products during the month of April. Now, if you're new here, how I usually do this is I will pick the number of favorites that corresponds with the number of the month. So ideally here in this video for April, I would have picked four, but I just tried a lot of new products this month and luckily I fell in love with a lot of them. So there's a couple more than four, but you know me, I justified them by like grouping them into categories to count as one. So yeah, you're in for a little treat. I mean, more is better, right? So I have a lot of goodies here. A lot of them are actually quite affordable, which is super exciting. Also, new thing, I never curl my hair. Can't remember the last time I curled my hair. I haven't curled my hair since I chopped it because for some reason I thought that if you have short hair, you can't really curl it. Still kind of feel the same, not really loving this curly hair on me. I'm thinking like if I got some hair pins, it would look cute to like pin it back because it's kind of in my face and driving me crazy. But anyway, but if you're interested in this makeup look, this is a springtime dewy skin, easy, quick makeup look that I did, and that will have already been uploaded to my channel, so I'll link that up here. Be sure to check it out after this video. But yeah, so we have a few more things than anticipated to get into, so without further ado, let's stop babbling and let's get on to my April favorites video. The Cover FX Custom Enhancer Drops, and this is in the shade Celestial. I am wearing this on the highest points of my cheeks. It just gives a very dewy, vibrant, glowy skin. It's not too much. It's not like overbearing. It looks really dewy and bright when the light hits the skin a certain way. If that is not blinding, I don't know what is. I actually purchased this quite a few months ago and never really got the chance to use it. I actually got it and threw it in my little cabinet behind me and totally forgot that I had it. But I've been incorporating this in my makeup routine almost every single day. It's really worth the price for how much you get in here. It's 15 milliliters, so it's half a full ounce. This is gonna last you a really long time. So granted, it is a little pricey, but it's gonna be really hard to go through this whole thing. You could take a few drops, mix it in with your foundation, put it all over the face. This way you get an overall really dewy, luminescent finish. That really works nice. What I would say is build up with it, so don't really put too much. One drop, mix it in with your foundation, put it everywhere. But what I've really been loving with this is just putting it at the highest points of my cheeks, meshing it into my skin. And I like to blend it with my finger. I find that that makes it even more natural and really melts it into the skin. Whereas putting it on with a sponge, it is a little bit more vibrant. So if you're into that, that is definitely a trick that you can do with this product. But it's really great and I love it so, so much. Another product that I've just been loving this past month is the Koki Be Bright Illuminating Concealer. This is super affordable. And what I love about this is that personally for me, I am really steering away from brighter under eyes and a brighter center of the face. Don't get me wrong, I do love that sometimes, but I've really been gravitating towards more of a natural look. So like today, this is really natural. I didn't even contour my face. So I like a concealer that matches my foundation a little bit more. There's kind of like a peachy undertone, so it helps to cover up the darkness and the dark circles underneath my eyes. It's almost like color correcting, so I'm a really big fan of this. I love that it is inexpensive. It's super cute. I like the size. I don't have my Tarte Shape Tape in front of me, but this is like a nice size. It's a lot smaller and a lot easier to travel with. This really counts as one. So collab makeup. I have done a few videos here on my channel. Actually, I think I did two. I recently did a dedicated video just to collab makeup, which is sold exclusively at Sally's. And I'm such a big fan of the brand. They have bomb eyeshadows. But collab got me with these two products. So this is the best mascara I have ever used. And if you watched my recent collab video, like I pledge allegiance to this mascara. This is better than my L'Oreal Telescopic, which has been my favorite for years and years and years. No one has ever come close to my L'Oreal Telescopic until now. This blows it out of the water. I'm actually wearing it today. It kind of creates like that spidery long lash effect, but also like clumps them together the perfect amount. It is affordable. It is drugstore. I love it. It's amazing. And then another collab product that I've just been eating up and wearing nonstop is this Soft Spot Sheer Blush in the shade Just For Fun. I love this. This is like the perfect pinky nude, and I look really good with cool tone shades. Cool tones look a lot better on my skin tone than warm tones, so this has really been my go-to. It lasts all day long. It's so nice. I love the color. I'm not wearing it today. Let's throw some on anyway. So I'm just gonna grab this Morphe E4, and I'm just gonna pat it on top. It's just like so pretty and so youthful, and it's like realistic to me. Like, it's not too blushy where it's like obvious that I'm wearing a blusher. Like, this is almost, it looks like my skin is really that color flush. You know what I'm saying? It's so pretty. It's so nice. I like that it's sheer, but it's not too shiny. I don't love a shiny, shiny blush, but I do like something that's like right on the border. So this is literally perfect. And if you feel me in what I'm saying, you're gonna really like this blush. My next favorite is skincare that I once again grouped together. So this will count as my number four, but I do have one more after this. So really we have five, but technically it's like seven. Yeah, no wonder I was no good at math growing up. Yeah, being on a YouTube channel, I'm sitting in front of a camera, I'm constantly looking at myself on my computer, in my videos, and I'm gonna be honest, like, my fine lines really, really bother me. And I wanted to do something to correct them, so I decided to switch up my nightly skincare routine. Now, if you watch my nightly skincare routine video, I do that 4 times a week. This one I do the remainder of the night. So I'm not switching it up on you, still do that, but this is a different routine that includes retinol. This is affordable. This is Neutrogena, and I've talked about this one specifically before. This is the Rapid Wrinkle Repair. I pair this with the Neutrogena Rapid Wrinkle Repair Regenerating Cream. Now, these both have retinol in them, and I've given my spiel about retinol so many times here, I don't wanna sound like a broken record, so I'm gonna keep it to a minimum. I'll wash my face at night, then I'll use a toner, as I typically do, and then for my cream, I will go in with this. I take like a quarter size of cream, and I distribute that all over my face and all over my neck. I will take one full pump, so it's like a pea size. I'll rub it between my fingers. I will dab it along my eyes to really get rid of those crow's feet or any of those wrinkles around my eyes. I'll do it around my mouth to get rid of my smile lines. I will let it soak into my skin, and then I will simply go to bed. And I just feel like overall, my fine lines are pretty much diminished. I mean, you can definitely still see them, but I feel like my skin looks a lot less wrinkly. And I'm telling you, you will notice a difference after the first use. My advice to you, do not apply retinol to your face during the day. Keep it to a nighttime only routine. Then when you wake up in the morning, wash it off your face. I like to use my Mario Badescu enzyme cleanser. You can use whatever face wash you have. Just make sure you really wash that retinol off your face and then apply a sunscreen. Apply a sunscreen. I cannot stress it enough. If you're using retinol, retinol is really sensitive to the sun, so apply a sunscreen before going out and your skin will be fine. It's really important. You don't want to damage your skin. The point of doing skincare is to correct your skin, so don't further damage it by going outside and not wearing an SPF. That will really save you from any, first of all, it'll save you from sun damage, it'll save you from free radicals. SPF is so, so important in anyone's routine, but especially if you are using retinol, make sure you are using SPF so your skin and the sun don't like clash, you don't have a bad reaction, you don't blow up. I already talked about my awful experience one too many times. I'm done talking about it. And then my fifth or eighth, whatever item you want to call it, I just had to mention this. I received this in my Ipsy bag. This is the Makeup Forever Wherever Walnut Lip Liner. I love this stuff. I'm wearing this today. It's like the perfect nude for me. It's dark enough where like I can overline my lips nicely. It's just like a really nice shade. And I didn't realize that like this lip gloss had really come off of my lips, so let me apply a little bit more. And I've talked about this lip gloss so many times, but it's sold out, so I'm not gonna mention it anymore, okay? We're not talking about it. Like, I literally take this everywhere with me, and it is a mini size, so it's literally perfect for my bag. So, that is it. I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments, what were your favorite products for the month of April? Have you used any of the products that I mentioned today? How do you feel about them? Anything that you guys wanna talk about? I love talking to you guys, so leave it down below in the comments section. Again, if you are not yet subscribed, please be sure to do so. I would love to have you here on my channel. I would love for you to become a part of my little Fortune Finds family. We are growing and it's exciting. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, give it a big thumbs up down below. Thank you guys so much for joining me. I had a wonderful time as always, and I will see you in my next one. Bye, finders. Mwah.